Question number 42. In a meeting of mimes, mime 1 goes through a displacement d1 vector equal to 4 meter I cap plus 5 meter j cap, and a mime 2 goes through a displacement d2 vector which is equal to minus 3 meter I cap plus 4 meter j cap. Now we have to answer for 4 questions. The first one is d1 vector cross d2 vector. The second question is d1 vector dot d2 vector. And the third question is d1 vector plus d2 vector dot with d2 vector. And the fourth question is the component of d1 vector along the direction of d2. So in this question, we have to answer for these 4 subdivisions. But the most important is the last subdivision, which is the component of d1 vector along the direction of d2 vector. Because the remaining all 3 questions are very easy, because we already practiced this type of question in the previous problems, right? Okay, let's we just go in order. So first of all, let's we write the given first. What is d1 vector? The d1 vector, which is equal to 4 meter I cap plus 5 meter j cap. And what's the d2 vector? Which is minus 3 meter I cap plus 4 meter j cap. So by using this, first we have to find d1 cross d2. Clear? So we have to go for matrix type. So d1 vector cross d2 vector, which is equal to matrix form of I, J, and K. And then we have to find the component of d1 vector from the vector equation. So here we have I, J, K. But you can see here, we have only I cap and J cap, right? So we have to write its component. So what's the component here? 4 meter for I cap and 5 meter for J cap. There is no K cap, so we have to put 0. So I'm going to write for d1. Which is 4 meter, and here 5 meter. In d1 there is no k cap, so what we have to do, we have to put 0. Likewise, you have to write the same thing for d2 vector. Here also we have I cap and j cap, but there is no k cap, so minus 3 is the component of I cap and its unit is meter. And likewise for j cap, it's 4 meter and there is no k cap. What we have to do, we have to put 0. So again, better we can make 3 rows and 3 columns. That will be easy for the explanation. So now here we have 3 rows and 3 columns, right? So I told you in the last problem, I cap take positive, J cap negative, and K cap positive. So how I can write? I can write positive of I cap. Now if you want to find the answer for I cap, you should not touch the first row as well as the first column. Only you have to deal with these 4 numbers. So 0 multiplied by 5 meter, which is 0, right? Likewise, in these directions, when you go, we have to put negative. So 4 meter multiplied by 0, again 0. That means for I cap, there is no answer. Likewise, we have to go for J cap, but J takes the value of negative. So J cap, and this time we should not touch the first row and the second column. And we have to deal only with 4 meter, 0, minus 3 meter, and 0. So now I have to multiply 0 with 4 meter. So what we will get? We will get 0. And this direction when you go, multiply. So you have to put negative. So minus 3 multiplied by 0, 0. That means for J cap also, there is no answer. Now we have to come for the K cap. The k cap takes the positive value, so I have to write k cap. And this time we should not touch the first row as well as the third column. Only we have to deal with this number. So this time I'm going to multiply 4 with this 4. So what you'll get? 4 meter multiplied by 4 meter, we will get a 16 meter square, right? 4 multiplied by 4 is, and meter multiplied by meter is meter square. And then these directions when you go for multiply, we have to put negative. So minus 3 multiplied by plus 5. So 15, that means minus 15 you will get. So minus 15 meter square. Clear? Now we have to simplify for getting the answer for D1 vector cross D2 vector. So which is equal to, there is no answer for I cap and J cap. Only you'll get the answer for K cap. So what you'll get? 0 and then 0. So we no need to write 0. So better directly we can go for K cap, right? So 16, so K cap, 16 meter square minus into minus, so plus 15 meter square, right? So minus into minus is plus. So we have plus 16 and plus 15. So what we have, which is 31 meter square K cap. Clear? So here meter square is the unit. So this is the answer for D1 vector cross D2 vector. Now we have to go for the second question, which is D1 vector dot with D2 vector. As I already mentioned, when you go for dot product, you have to multiply I with I and J with J, right? So better I can write the equation one more time. So D1 vector, which is equal to 4 meter I cap plus 5 meter J cap, and D2 vector, which is equal to minus 3 meter I cap plus 4 meter J cap. Now what we are going to do, we are going to find the dot product. So D1 vector dot D2 vector, which is equal to, I told you last time, we have to multiply only I with I and J with J. So minus 4 multiply by minus 3, which is minus 12. And I dot I takes the value of 1, right? And here we have to multiply J with J. So 5 multiply by 4, which is 20. Again, J dot with J, we get the answer for 1. So we have minus 12 plus 20. And again, we have the unit here, right? So which is meter square. And here also we have meter square. So don't forget the unit. We have to give the answer in terms of a unit. So minus 12 meter square and plus 20 meter square. So minus 12 plus 20, we will get 8 meter square. So this is the answer for the second part. Clear? Now we have to go to the third part. D1 vector plus D2 vector. So again, I need the equation because that is easy for our easy for solving the question easily. Okay, so I can write D1 and D2 again. So D1 vector, which is equal to 4 meter I cap plus 5 meter J cap, and D2 vector, which is equal to minus 3 meter I cap plus 4 meter J cap. And this time, first I have to give importance for the information given inside the bracket. So first I have to find D1 plus D2. So D1 plus D2, which is equal to, I have to add only I with I and J with J. So 4 plus of minus 3. That means we have answer as 1. So 1 meter I cap plus 4 plus 5 plus 4, you got 9 meter J cap. After we find the answer, we have to find the dot product with D2. So better I can write D2 here because we need for simplify this question. So what's the equation for D2? So D2 here is minus 3 meter I cap plus 4 meter J cap. Now we have to find the dot product. Dot product means we have to multiply, right? So 1 multiply by minus 3 is minus 3 meter square I cap dot I cap 1 plus 4 multiply by 9. So what's the number for 4 multiply by 9, which is 36. So 36 meter square, and J dot J is 1 So we have to simplify. So minus 3 meter square plus 36 meter square. We got the answer here as 33 meter square. So this is the answer for D1 vector plus D2 vector dot product with D2 vector. So this is the answer for the third question. Now we have to answer the last question, which is important, and also it's a different type. Part D. In part D, we have to find the component of D1 along the direction of D2. So what's the meaning for component of D1 along the direction of D2? So for that, let's we just first see the formula for A vector dot B vector. So we already know A vector dot B vector is nothing but magnitude of A, magnitude of B multiplied by cosine theta, right? Likewise, if you apply this D1 and D2 for this formula, we will get D1 vector dot D2 vector, which is equal to D1 D2 cosine theta. So here, if you have the question of component of D1 along the direction of D2, means what you have to do, you have to frame this equation like this. So D1 cosine theta, you have to keep it one side, and the remaining terms you have to move to the left hand side. That means we have to bring this D2 to the left hand side of the denominator. So if you rearrange this equation, what you will get? D1 cosine theta, which is equal to D1 vector dot D2 vector divided by D2. So here D2 is nothing but the magnitude, right? So now I am going to use this formula for getting the answer for D part. So let's rewrite the rule here. So D1 cosine theta, which is equal to D1 vector dot D2 vector divided by D2 magnitude. Now D1 dot D2, we already got the answer from the first part. So I can directly take the answer from the part B. So D1 cosine theta, which is equal to 8 meter square divided by, I have to find the magnitude of D2. So what should be the value of magnitude of D2? So let's we find the answer here. Minus 3 square, that means minus 3 meter square, right? So minus 3 meter square plus 4 meter square. And we will get the answer here as this is 9 and this is 16. So 25 meter square we'll get. So this is 5 meter, right? So in place of D1 vector, so what I have to do, I have to write 5 meter. So meter get cancelled with this meter. So finally, we got the answer here as D1 cosine theta, which is equal to 8 divided by 5 is 1.6 meter. So this is the answer for the last part. Thank you.